Well, you know, one of the things that was beautiful about it was that there was a familyhood that made it very easy. I consider Okoro one of my mentors in that sense, in that a lot of us who got started in television through Bird and in other areas of entertainment, we came out of Bird, and that experience taught us a lot. We knew what was at stake. We didn't know how historical it was, but mm-hmm. we knew because of the battle it took to get there that all eyes were on us, and that when we were there and we were working, it was a professional attitude, it was an energy, and there was a love. There was a strong love, and I think that came through on the shows themselves.
Yeah, it certainly does. And that kind of battle sometimes can create the best art.
Mm-hmm. By the way, you know, of course, out of the 24 episodes that were originally produced, there are only two known episodes still in existence, because all the other episodes, according to the station, were accidentally erased because they were done on videotape.
Accidentally.
Accidentally.
Right.
Coral Johnson, when it came to the actual, the holding on to the show itself, did you, as this team, obviously you tried the best you could to keep the show going. What would you do?
Yes,
I imagine that must have been very, very difficult to see it go.
Well, we were surprised that they cut it at the time that they, because we thought they, we, one of the things that we had asked that is that we would be afforded the knowledge of the, how the money was spent and when it was, you know, as it was spent. But they never did that with it, and they never allowed us to know, but they came out saying the money was gone, because they wanted to cut it off. By that time, it was getting so much publicity, they had wanted to stop it. So they said the money was gone. Yeah. And as Harold said, we found out that they ended up sending money back to Ford Foundation.
This gets to the question, Temple Hemphill, of the fact that in today's, the media today, the idea is, the more commercially available a show is, the more popular the show happens to be, mm-hmm. the more of an opportunity you will have. Mm-hmm. But in reality, the filters you mentioned before, as well as this absolute, completely historic example, mm-hmm. show that actually the more popular a show is, the more of a threat it can be. Uh-huh. Is that pretty much the case in terms of the way things are even to this day? Probably more so, perhaps?
I think it brings up The Wire. I only actually watched a few episodes of The Wire, but it, from all accounts, it was a smart show, even though it dealt with, well, not even though, it dealt with crime and the inner city of Baltimore, but it also was just very smart. It was well written. It was just a smart show. I think it was a threat, though, on some level to... So I think it was a threat. I want to go back, though, to something you said about how can we get more people behind the scenes in terms of minorities and responsibility. I think we have one of my Hispanic students, he's working the cameras today. It's people, more minorities. Hi, Valentin. we need more minorities to understand the responsibility that I believe there should be a responsibility in terms of gatekeeping. We, 40 years from, you know, 1970, we should be in a different place in terms of minorities and gatekeeping and entertainment.
Let me tell you the beginning of that. After the show was over, we formed an organization called TCB to go around to all of the stations and see who had any black employees. There were none. That was 1971, and that year, the ICC was investigating all stations, all radio and television stations, and they had to do a report. Every 3 years, they have to do this report. And so we got the organization of TCB and found out that there were none in front of the camera or behind the camera, and that I had been the first director. So we went to the ICC and wrote this whole thing up. And after that, they forced them, every station, to have some black employee in television and radio.
Something I like you said, it wasn't just a group of filmmakers and actors who were just in place because they were African American. Mm-hmm. They were very qualified, mm-hmm. very, very qualified. And I think that's key, that's integral. We're talking about gatekeepers who are qualified, just having a seat at the table.
Right.
More Spike Lees,
right.
More Lee Daniels. So that's what we're talking about. It's not just a handout.
One of the things that occurs to me, though, is that how often a corporate executive listening to this show, perhaps, would say, yeah, sure, of course, mm-hmm. we need more minorities involved. We need more programs like, mm-hmm. well, that will give us characters like the Huxtable family, for instance, right? The uplifting story, which is important, but that uplifting story that will, in the end, bring the African-American experience into the context of the middle class. Yet a bird of the wire is a bird of the feather, excuse me, Johnny Cash song. Well, it's apropos in a way, because we have, you know, a bird of a feather is about the class experience as well, about struggling in the urban working class experience,
exactly.
and struggling sometimes with the African American middle class. Mm-hmm. Harold Rush, can you speak to that a little bit? Because that is radically different than what we would experience today.
Well, one of the things that if we look back 40 years, it's really significant that in today's Chicago, at least,
yeah.
there are no black-owned television stations.
Yeah.
There's only one or two black-owned radio stations. This is, for me, is a problem because we can't control what we don't own.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we could do more for our images and if we owned our own media.
And let the expression happen freely. Without having to fight.
Right.
The filters are going to be there. Professional filters are always there.
Right.
But the fight itself is what mm-hmm. takes up so much energy. Mm-hmm. Final thoughts from this wonderful panel on this incredibly important program of television history. Temple Hemphill?
You know, I'd have to say as a media professor, I just encourage my students to really consider and just behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. Consider positions behind the scenes in entertainment. Become a gatekeeper. Mm. That's really where the power is often.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd say to my students. So.
And organize.
And not just KKC students and CCC students, anyone viewing this. Parents, encourage your students to consider, and that's in radio, this in general, mm-hmm. the media industry in general, which includes the film industry,
and
radio.
And the internet in every form.
Public relations, advertising, you control the images. You have a say if you're a gatekeeper.
And be prepared. Mm. Be prepared. When you go there, you know you can do what you asked to do, or what you're applying to do, you can do it and do it well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very important that you prepare yourself in the beginning.
Be educated and know your craft.
Precisely.
And you certainly absolutely do as a pioneer as well as even today. As an artist.
Well, with me, my background was in theater, and it was just a matter of applying it to television.
It makes perfect sense. Harold Rush?
I would say this, that one of the most important things I think people can do is learn the history.
Mm-hmm.
Because without knowing our history, we can't figure out where we're going.
Yeah.
And when you think about Bird, most people do not know that history.
And
I appreciate WYCC for doing this.
Well, we appreciate you being here, all of you. Excellent intellectuals as well as artists, and that kind of pioneering spirit, I think, came through today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
One cannot talk about the history of television in America without considering the influence television has had on American culture. African American actors, directors, producers, and others have had significant impact on television throughout its history. In the process, these artists not only entertained, they broke barriers, enlightened their audiences, and helped move the medium forward. For the professors, I'm Max Galeas. Until next time, keep learning and be wise.